First one I want to talk about is Orphan Black.
Okay, is this a show or a movie?
A TV show. The season, the
TV
first
show.
season of Orphan Black just ended a few weeks ago.
Okay.
Orphan Black season 1, 3.5 out of 5. Tatiana Maslany's performance is undeniably a jaw-dropping feat of technical brilliance. And the story had the right twists and stakes to keep me churning through the episodes. But so much character development, dialogue, production value, sense of place fell flat. And I'm not surprised, but I didn't get anyone responding. Now, Orphan Black, I don't think anyone watched it,
Yeah, I
but
don't know anything about it.
it became a real critic's darling this season. All the critics I read and listen to were like, "Everyone, please, I'm begging you, go see this TV show." So I did. You know, I figure that's the type of thing that I do, see TV shows that critics like. So I watched it. And it's on BBC America.
Okay.
It's not British, but it is a BBC America original. I guess mostly Canadian cast and crew. And the main thing that I have to, you know, echo everyone in the world who talks about this is I really cannot say enough about just the technical brilliance of Tatiana Maslany's performance. Without spoiling, let me just say that she plays a lot of different characters, and the way she changes their postures, their intensity, their accents, their motivations, their everything is amazing. It's really, really good.
Wow. Okay.
And like I said, I watched it because it was getting a lot of buzz from TV critics. They're begging people to watch it, so I did. But like, it's BBC America original, and it reminded me of British TV in a lot of ways. And you know me, I'm a little biased against British TV generally. And I have to say this had a lot of the stuff that I tend not to like about British TV, unfortunately. I feel like it's going back in time to TV, to American TV before The Sopranos. You know, just it looks sort of cheap. A lot of the characters aren't really very well rounded. And they take a lot of liberties with the plot and the story and how things fit together. I just found myself a lot of little questions that I wish they'd explained better or backed up with more evidence. Those are nitpicky things, and I get it. I know that I'm nitpicking here. But one of the things I like about TV of the last decade plus is that it's been elevated into just this serious craft, a serious art form, really. And this show just doesn't rise to the level of that. And I'm going to say it doesn't rise to the level of professionalism, which may
Yeah,
be
that's fair.
unfair, but this is sort of how I feel about it.
But now you have me all interested because of that technical performance. I do like seeing stuff like that, but I don't know if I want to see it. If it was a movie, then I'd totally watch it. But a whole show for that, it's a little harder. I don't know. How many episodes is this thing?
10 episodes, and
Okay.
I will definitely say it's definitely worth seeing for the performance. And also it has some good cliffhangers and twists that maybe want to figure out what would happen and keep coming back every episode. At 3.5 stars, it's a good show, and a lot of people like it a lot more than I did. So it's one that if you're interested in, I recommend checking out.
Okay, I'm adding it to the queue.